if they're fasted or healing. But if you'll make up your mind to stay within the law, follow the laws. Obey those in authority over us. Now, I've got a lot of friends real mad around the world because a policeman shot somebody. But if you go back and look at the video, there's zero honor for the police. Zero. The policeman says, stop, they keep coming. And I don't care what race, and only fools are racist, but I don't care what race it is. And I'm sure there's a lot of racism. I don't doubt that around the world. I see it. There's racism toward whites. Like I tell some of my friends, who on earth would want to be white? I don't. Wear anything other than white skin? Not that I know of. I see beautiful dark skin. I said, Lord, why couldn't you have done that to me? I spent hours out in the sun trying to get rid of ugly white. But honor is real critical in our life. And if you don't, do you remember the lady that beat on her son? They ran on TV because he was out in the, and she began to hit him on top of the head. He was running for her. I said, Mama, you came back. She said, just like my mom. But my mother and daddy were very strong about obeying the law. Family, just obey the law. Don't try to slip past the law.
No, sir.
Yeah, I don't want that. Yeah, you can move. No. Magic house is just gone. You can move. Everything's good. Thank you, though. I'm going to move this. We'd like to move my chair here in 3 or 4 minutes. But just make up your mind to follow the law. If you'll stay inside the law, stress leaves. There's a lot of unnecessary stress. They tell me that stress will even stop you. Now they did. I don't know who they are. I don't remember. They seem to be a family around the world. They're all related today. But they tell me that it even stops you from losing weight. That if you have stress. Dr. Lee, is that right? Are you a doctor? You know that I don't. Okay. Just follow the law. And insist that your family follow the law. Insist that your son follow the law. Insist that your daughter follow the law. Let me tell you a horrible thing that happened in my life. One of my best friends and great supporters, way up north, was training his son. And another job, very wealthy. He had 3 or 4 businesses and he was training his son. Wonderful son. Whole family of preachers. He was a businessman's son. And I get a call late one night. He had just been killed in a car accident. Well, I couldn't grasp it. It was too much. Just too much. Oh, God, why did you let that happen? We all do that. And we blame God for everything bad. Never felt good. And I just didn't know what did. I said, how could that happen? So as we begin to talk, he's crying. And I'm just stunned. But found out that in the highway, you know how there's a broken yellow line? And then if you're permitted by the law to pass somebody, there's a line on the outside, so you can, meaning you can go. If they put a line on the inside where you're driving, that means you're not permitted to pass anybody. Now, the people that put these signs out there are trying to protect us. somewhere he lost respect for those laws. For those laws. He decided he could pass, that he would drive so fast that whoever was coming on the hill couldn't stop it. He'd get there fast. He did it. Horrible. And instantly I remember the Assemblies of God put out little papers when I was 9 years old living in Orange, Texas. Daddy pastored the church at 1106 Park Avenue. And Mother would always read a little paper called Junior Trail. Because they had different papers for different ages of people. I still remember my mother reading to us in the back seat. And she read to us from the Junior Trail. And the story was this. There was a man and his son. Son loved to be with his daddy. They just everywhere, drove everywhere. And they pulled into a place. And there was a sign, no parking. And his little boy said, Daddy, the sign says no parking. And his daddy laughed and said, Son, I'll park anywhere I want to. And a matter of just a year or two, actual story, the young man decided to do the same thing as his father and broke the law. And it was horribly killed. What your children see you do, they believe is okay. And even when you get tired of repeating yourself, remember that repetition has more power than truth. Repetition is more powerful than truth. That explains the 6 million deaths in Germany of the Jewish people by Adolf Hitler. He repeated a lie until it created the illusion of truth. Today, whatever you do, just make up your mind. I was with a preacher friend of mine just a few weeks ago. Found out he hadn't even paid his taxes in 3 years. Well, I believe in God to just pay my taxes. If you decide and say relax, if you decide to obey the law, you won't feel stress. You won't feel stress. I've had people say before I went on a platform, they said, are you nervous about what? What would you be nervous for? I've never felt God any more in any church service than I needed every single day of my life. Have you made mistakes? Horrible mistakes. They're really funny lately. Relax. Be who you are. Don't try to act like somebody you're not. Be real. If you're always genuine and real, you'll never have anybody change their mind about you. If they're going to decide whether they like you or not, they get on the place. They love me. They know. What's your difference more than I give? If you like, I'm going to talk to you about it. If we're friends, if we're not, I'll let you know. But if you're a liar, and I like it, I'm going to talk to you. I'm going to set you down. Probably with your wife. You know. Now, why did you go do that? Not you. Not you. Anybody but you. She said, I could accept this from anybody else, but not my girl. I was 8. And she just looked at me. She said, I can't tell you how disappointed I am. I'm just sick of it. God, I can't believe you. She said, anybody else? Yes, but not you. If I'm a recall it was 200 lashes. They did 100 lashes. You know, I would never cheat again on something like this. I make it right over and over and over. When I was 10, we had a neighbor that had two horses. I think it was two. Maybe four. There were several of them. I would ride the horse. Not with permission, you know, just ride the horse. Oh, two horses. Two. We have a church, as you know. And we didn't have any money. We didn't have anything. Our boat had brought us a lot of food. And that's kind of how we survived. Mother looks out the door and says, "What are y'all doing?" We were throwing the pecans. They had had rain, and all of the pecans had fallen from the neighbor's pecan tree. So he and I were picking up the pecans and throwing them over. I was 10. Over picking up the pecans that were on our crop. What are y'all doing? I still see her. I still see her shaking. But throw every single one of them back. Oh, Mama. She stood there. I asked her one day, I said, "Do you ever wish you wouldn't have had any of us children?" She said, "Not many times." I started like a little baby when I was 17 and 18, and my mother would never go to bed if I was out of the house. Daddy would, Daddy could sleep. But mother wouldn't. And when I walked, still see myself walking through the door 38, 14, 20. And she'd see my face red. Now, I don't remember anything so wonderful as to make my face red. She said, "Not a lick." Oh, teach your children. You can have a stress-free life. You'll stay honest. Tell the truth the first time. There is nothing more free than being truthful. A young man working for David Wilkinson traveled with me for 6 months for Teen Challenge. Somehow, nobody ever persuaded you that there was a benefit. Is there anything I want you to take away from this birthday weekend? Get integrity. Your strength. But just tell the truth. I had a friend of mine trying to go through customs with some jewelry that he had bought overseas. And he told the guy, "Oh no, I brought it with me." He ended up 7 years in jail. A preacher. I've had people with me say, "Now you're not going to turn in this money that you just received." I said, "Of course." "What will they do?" I said, "Count it." "Just count it." Oh, be straight, folks. Be straight. Live a relaxed life. Be straight. Tell the truth to your kids. Tell the truth to yourself. And there is a reward in it. There is a reward in it. A young man that's been on late night show in all over the world, he's known as the Grandmaster of Surprise. And he always comes to every conference. I wondered if he would be here. Now, somebody want to move the chair there for me? Now, some people don't like magic, but I like Walt Disney in my life. I like Disney way. Magic is of the devil. Why does it make me so happy? Pastor KK, Dr. Mike. I've been hearing people upset over Halloween. I've had people tell me, "Halloween's up the devil." Oh, not to me, it's free candy. No witch has ever hit me with her broom. I still love Halloween. I'm still tempted to go from door to door. When people come to my house on Halloween, I like to give them money. I try to make it all I ever do. But I love Halloween. If you knew where it came from, you know what? The devil may have created iPad, but I still like it. Now, if you get mad today, it's okay. We're going to come back for another session. Be kind of happy. Magic Al is a man. Oh, yes, sir. There, verse 2. Let us know when we're supposed to clap. Is everything in place? Al, is it all right if I keep this pair of soap here? Is that okay? All right. All right. Look at somebody next to you and say, don't you dare get mad. God's going to make you happy. All the children are a part of this.
If we work out, they do it every time. If we're just
to all of our church family, please welcome with a big round of applause, two-time Merlin Award winner and the Grandmaster of Surprise, Magic Al. Come on.